Engineering, I'm Alan. In this video, we're looking at digital readouts, or DRO, and that's for the mill or the lathe. I'm going back to basics for beginners. With the help of Banggood, I've been given a set of glass scales and a display, free of charge, so I can test and review the product. I can show you how they work and how to measure the scale size you need for your machine. How to order on the internet and check your order. We also see what you get in the kit. So why fit DRO? Well, it turns your machine into a measuring machine. The scales are independent of the lead screw, so it gives you a direct reading of the table or saddle or cross slide position and movement. No more backlash to consider. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. How do you find out what size scale you need or what you should order for your machine? On this machine, this is the Warco Super Major. If I'm looking for a scale to fit this axis, I can wind the table forward as far as it will go. Now on here, I've got the switch box for the power feed. Now I know I can take that off and get this face of the table to come up to the wheel. So when I wind out and this touches the wheel, I know I have at least 25mm of travel there. So I want to add 25mm onto my scale so that I know I can take that box off and still come to the end of this slide with the scale still reading. The length of travel is 230, because this, I've added this so it can come to here, 230 plus the inch on the end, 255, so I'm just over the 250. So I wouldn't buy a 250 scale because I know I've got the chance of hitting the end of the scale and not getting the full length. So I go up to the nearest 50mm, which is 300. So I'd buy a 300 scale for that. That gives me an inch nearly each end to be able to centralise it. So a 300 scale, which would actually come at 150mm more, so you'd be talking about a 450mm scale in length. Now you need to know that, because if you haven't got the length to fit the scale, you'll have to use some sort of bracket or something to make up the difference. So for that I need a 300 scale. If you know that the length's going to be bigger by 150mm, that may come in useful. If I need to cover 130mm, I would order 150mm, which is a 6-inch one, so I've got a little bit of play at each end of the reader. But the difference is, on this machine, that would give me a total length 300mm, about that. Now if I measure 300mm, it comes from the bottom to about here. Now that would give me a problem, because this casting is a gearbox. At the bottom I'm okay, that much at the top I'm okay, because that's the lid to the casting and it has some cap heads already in here. And I have checked this when I took the cover off, I can drill into this. So I don't want to buy a shorter scale which will do the job, but end up having to drill the fixing hole straight through into the gearbox. For an extra couple of pounds, I'll go to the longer scale, so I know I'm going to cover a fixing mount point there and a fixing point here on the scale. This is the scale, the silver part. So when I've fitted that scale, I can drill into the casting each end and tap it, and I know I'm not going to hit the gearbox. That's the end of the traverse on the motor. What I've done is just put a mark in the middle of the column so I know the head fitted in the middle will come there. And go to the other end, I'll put a mark on this end in the centre of the column and just measure between the two marks to get your overall scale length. So here we've got 440. Now I'm going to go up to the nearest 50mm, which would be 450, and then I want to add another 50mm to that, so that'll be a 500 scale, measuring distance of 500. That gives me an inch each end to play with. But the overall length will come in around 650. So just make sure that 650, you still have the ability to screw into your table at 650.
Now we'll go over to the website and see how we order the parts.
If you click on the link under the video title, it should bring you to this page. At the moment, this is the Chinese page here, and you've got the US page, and there is a UK Banggood as well. So we'll just deal with the Chinese page at the moment. You will find if you go to the UK page, they're more expensive, and that is because you are paying UK VAT and any import duties. If you buy direct from China, you don't pay that, but you may be charged that by the customs people when it comes into the country. So don't assume because it's cheaper from China, you're going to get it at a cheaper price. If you're worried about the duty, just buy it off the UK site. So the first thing you need to do is decide which box you need. That's a three-axis one, and there's a two-axis one. So the three-axis one is £86. If that's the one you want, you just press add to cart. Once we've got the control box, we can continue shopping. Now we can shop for the scales. We need a 300 scale. So if along here, the numbers come up. 300, click on the 300. Make sure that the picture changes to the 300 scale. There we go. And then click add to cart. Don't worry if you've clicked it wrong. You can take it off the list in a moment. So we've got 300, we want a 200, add to cart, and we want a 500, add to cart. So once you have the parts that you need, view your cart, and you can see here I've ordered a 500, one, that's £39. 200 at £30, 300 at £34, and three axis display, it says there 3AE, which is three axis display, that's £84. Now, if that's okay, everything's right, you can press PayPal to check out or proceed to check out. If you've not got an account with Banggood, you'll need to set up with your name, address, phone number
and email details.
That's so they email you the code for the tracking code, and that'll tell you when they've sent it and you can track where it is in the world. So once you've proceeded to check out, you've done those few things, the goods will be dispatched.
So the scales and the display unit have arrived, and I'll go through them one by one, tell you what you get in the kit, and then we'll look at how you fit them. I'll be discussing fitting them to the machine. Also go through a lot of questions that people have asked me, and I'll try and give you the answers. So I'm starting as if you know nothing at all about digital readout. We'll start off with the digital readout display. This display is three axis, and that means it's X, Y, and Z. This is the two axis reading. You just have the X and Y. Everything else is the same. It'll measure inches or millimeters. You can halve the distance between two points. So what I'll do is go through this, show you what you get in the kit. First of all, you get the display. Let me show you on the back. On the back of the display, you have your X, Y, and Z inputs. If you're only buying XY, you'll have XY. You have an on-off switch and the main power input. The cable you get is that one, but on the two that I've had, it has that type of plug. I believe it's Canadian. on both of mine, I've cut the plug off and fitted a British socket, and I've changed the fuse in the socket to a 2 or 3 amp. You don't need a 13 amp fuse for this, although this has got a fuse already built in here. On the bottom of the display you have a bracket. I've fitted this bolt on that comes in the kit, and that fits on this bar, and this bar then has another bracket that you fit on the other end with the bolt through, and you can screw this to your machine or to a wall, and it'll just let you pivot the screen. With the screen you get this cover, plastic cover. Don't throw it away, think it's just a plastic bag that comes with it. It's a bit thicker than a normal plastic bag. It has cutouts, so when you put this onto the back, you can see that the cutouts still let you access the electrics. And what this does, it stops dirt on the screen. If you've got oily hands and you're pressing the buttons, you're not transferring the oil on, you can wipe this clean. Keeps your screen clean, and you get all the fittings in a plastic bag that comes with it. Now that's the screen. With the readout display you get the instruction manual. This one covers the 2-axis and the 3-axis display, and it gives you some operating instructions. The only problem with this manual that came with it is the instructions given. The list of switches on the machine, there's more on here than there is on the machine. So this is obviously an instruction manual for a more advanced unit. And I found that reading through this, the translation is not easy to understand. The manual I had with my 2-axis readout was a lot better. The difference is it had the manufacturer's name on the front, where this doesn't. 49 pages long, where my other manual is 75 pages. Now with the glass scales, this is what you get in the kit. You get a cover. This is an aluminium extrusion, and this stops any swarf or cutting fluid getting onto the reader. The scale comes with the plug already fitted. Some of the features I'll show you. On this end of the scale is a label, and it tells you this particular one has got a 350mm length. That's the reading length of the scale. In fact, the scale length will be larger than that. It is a 5 volt scale and it's 5 microns.
So that means it's set up to read 5 micron increments.
When you fit these, they should be fitted with the reader underneath. If you fit them that way up, all the dirt and swarf will go straight into the gap. And as the scale reader comes along, it opens up this guard, this dirt guard, and it would let the swarf and dirt in, so the scale wouldn't last long. They're supposed to be fitted that way, and then this guard goes over the top to protect it. So any swarf or dirt or oil would drip onto here and run down the front and come below the scale. This is the reader. Got some details on the bottom. Should match 5 micron, 5 volt. Matches the scale, so you know you've got the right reader on there. This is just hold on with cable ties to stop it moving up and down in transit. So your fitting points for this are each end. You can see there's a steel block already machined on the end. You can put the screw through this way or up through out this hole. They are made slightly larger than the screws, so you have got a bit of wiggle room on there. On this way you can slide it up and down to get the distance that you need from flat surface. So what you get with the scale is the bracket to fit it and a bag of nuts and bolts and cable ties and the washers, and there's some smaller screws. So the head is held between there with some washers and cap heads, and you've got adjustment in and out and a little adjustments on the side. There are two ways of fitting it. You can either have the head reading head fixed, so you bolt it onto there, that's fixed, and the scales bolted onto your slide, so the scale will move up and down and the reading head will stand still. Or sometimes you can have your reading head that moves up and down and the scale stands still. And the other thing I need to point out is these brackets are about 5mm thick, and the reason for that, you're turning your machine into a measuring machine, so you shouldn't really use very thin brackets that flex and move, because your reading will then be impaired because of the stability of the system. And you can see why the scale comes out longer than the measuring length, because when this moves to the end, the measurement's there, so you're about inch and a half in on this end and the same on the other end, so you lose 3 inches off your measuring length plus the width of the fitting block on each end. So the way they do it is you say what measuring length you need and they add the distance on each end, which adds up to about 150mm longer than your measuring length.
The two axes on the lathe are Z and X, but you won't find a Z and X box, it'll be X and Y. And on the milling machine, you've got Z axis, a Y axis, X axis, which match up with the display. Oh well, that's it for this week. Next week we'll continue fitting the readouts, looking at the display and going over some of the features on the display. I hope that was useful, hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.